Okay. Good morning. So we have started with two-dimensional elasticity problem, and as a first case I took plane stress. I have explained the meaning of plane stress problem. I will take the other kinds later so that there is no confusion. So we are discussing only plane stress problem, and so yesterday we saw I gave you, I think you have to work little hard, derive the equations as I told you in terms of displacement. There will be two equations of equilibrium in terms of u and v, displacements u and v, and that is the governing equations in terms of displacement, which normally is solved by, if it can be solved analytically, yes, for simple domains it can be solved. So for simple, as a boundary value problem, u and v, so this is the partial differential equation, two in two unknowns, and with boundary conditions on x and y, along x equal to 0, x equal to a, y equal to 0, y equal to b, something of that kind, so you can always solve it. So try to get idea about analytical solution, but then that method works only for simple geometry and materials, and of course loading also. Now if you have anything complicated, then the method fails, and therefore finite element comes handy, because here we can fill up the area by smaller elements of different shapes. So yesterday we derived the constitutive relation, and we said that this plane stress continued. So today plane stress (2D) plane stress problem. So here z dimension is small, and these quantities sigma z, tau z x and tau z y, these are 0, all the three. So we are left with, and I derive the constitutive relation. So constitutive relation if you invert, so we can write this equal to E by 1 minus nu square epsilon x plus nu E by 1 minus nu square epsilon y. Similarly, this equal to nu E. Yesterday we derived this, and g equal to and then if you want to bring in this form, so I can write it 1 minus nu, supposing I multiply this by E into 1 minus nu divided by 2, then it will become 1 minus nu square. Numerator and denominator multiply by this, so this is also gamma x y. Yes. So I can write this in matrix form, sigma x, sigma y, tau x y, stress written in terms of strains. See, we started with strains written in terms of stresses. Why did we write? Because that is simpler to derive. Physically it can be derived, you know, just by physical consideration. It is easier to derive. I cannot derive directly this, no. At least I cannot derive, you know, some of you can do it. But then that can be derived, and then you invert it. So then this is, if you take E divided by 1 minus nu square common, so you are left with 1 nu 0 nu 1 0 0 0 E, not E, 1 minus nu by 2. These are engineering strain components. Okay. This one is the stress. So this is this matrix, if you call it by a vector sigma, components of 3, I think this is what we have been doing. We define sigma as vector strain, we define another as epsilon x, epsilon y, gamma x y. These are engineering strain components. See, gamma x y is the physical shear strain. You must be knowing the difference between engineering shear strain and tensorial strain component. Half of this is called tensorial strain component, but that has no physical meaning. This gamma has physical meaning, half of gamma tensorial, because if you take half of this, then that becomes, then all this, this becomes a tensor, then this works as a tensor. I mean, just like stress, strain also can be taken then as a tensor. So this, and this matrix I call it by elasticity matrix. So I denote it by capital E. Capital E is bold face. So it is not Young's modulus, but it is a bold face, and this is strain. So we have established this E. Yesterday we did it. So this I just want to, because this is important in every problem of that we do. Then after this, then I told you also that you please derive this finite element equations using weighted residual, taking those differential equation, two differential equation, derive this using the weighted residual method. I will do it by energy method. So I will have, now let us first be clear about, so I will have a u vector at any consisting of u and v. So if I can express u, which is a function of x, y, as using Ritz method, as, see, in any domain, now we are talking of any domain, this is my x, y, and this is the point. Now let us construct a, let us take a small element. Now the simplest element that we can think of two dimensional is a triangle, three noded triangle, and this was the first element which was developed in 1956 paper of the four authors, and also in the 1960 paper of Clough that he presented. So, both these papers contain only this element, and that is a triangular element. So, if you have a two dimensional, because both these papers discuss plane stress problem. So, if you, let us say this whole domain is divided by triangular. So, one such element is a triangle with the nodes 1, 2, 3. Now, since it is a two dimensional, so we have to now, in one dimensional we were always numbering our nodes like this, positive direction. Now, this is two dimension. Now, how to note it? So, we have to do clockwise or anti-clockwise. The convention is we do it in anti-clockwise. You start from anyone, any point here 1, 2, 3, okay, node 1, 2, 3. Now, coordinate of 1, so this is, this one is your P1, this is P2 and this is your P3, three points are there. So, the coordinate of P1 will be x1, y1, p2, x2, y2, p3. These are the three coordinates, and they have been numbered anti-clockwise in two dimension, because we have to follow one. And the reason for anti-clockwise is, see, if you take x, y like this, go like this, so then that you will get z direction, x, y, z, right-handed screw system. So, perpendicular to the plane. So, if let us say there is a point P here, P inside this element, having coordinate x, y, can you express the displacement of P in terms of the displacement of P1, P2, P3? Yes, it can be expressed if you know, let us say, nodal displacement. So, yes, it will be N1, it will be, I'm just saying, what is N1, that we will find out, but right now I am just saying U and V are point P displacement. P has got two displacement, U and V. So, that can always be written as N1. This is a shape function U1 is not a function of x, y. It is a, when it is displacement at node x1, y1 whose coordinates are x1, y1. So, at node 1 plus N2 xy U2 plus N3 xy U3, and similarly also any variable, you do not have to, this also by the same, this is the simplest. Yes, but you see I have written here approximately. So, this is of the form that is U xy of point P is written as sigma ni, which will be a function of xy into ui, I going from 1 to 3 here, I is going to 1 to, let us say, n, and n is 3 here. Similarly, V x, y sigma I 1 to n n I x, y Vi. By the way, who gave this form? Any quantity, displacement, pressure, temperature, anywhere in the domain can be expressed in terms of neighborhood point pressures, displacement, temperatures. Who gave this formula? I think this I have told you in one dimension. This is one form. I mean, this is the, instead of writing it in terms of polynomial, this is one form. This is a form which is desirable in finite element. So this one is, who gave this? Yes, Reitz. R-I-T-Z. Reitz gave this, that anything can always be expressed like this. But then it is approximate, because this n has to be infinite. We are limiting it to 3 or 10 or 20, 50. It should be infinity, then it is exact. There are infinite number of points, and then you should take so many points, you know, in the domain. That we cannot take, so approximation is entering here itself. So approximation, you must keep in mind that we are entering, this is called discretization error, because we are now limited by number of nodes. We cannot take, because there is no point in considering very complicated, you know, 1000 nodes, then the whole algebra will become very messy. So our element has to be simple. Okay. So this is, now I can write this. I will, instead of writing every time u as a function of x, y, ni as a function of x, y, I will just write ni and u. That means it is a function of x, y. Everything is a two-dimensional quantity except this u, I, v, I. Those are nodal values. So, u is, and no, let me write out in matrix form directly. This can be written as, now normally we arrange the displacement of nodes nodal wise. So I will write here u1 v1 u2 v2 u3. This is the standard procedure. You know, we do not write u1, u2, u3 first, then v1, v2, v3 first. Node wise, all the displacement of a particular node is written together. So, this is my nodal displacement, 6 degrees of freedom, 3 nodes, a simple triangle. So, I can write this as, now I have to fill up this matrix. So, this one will be u1. Yes, n1, then next one is 0, v1 will contain 0 here, first row, u2, n2, then 0, and then n3, 0. Next line, 0, n1, 0, n2, 0, n3. So, this one is your u vector, which is written as this, and that is approximated to this. This matrix, now in one dimension, you see we have done one dimension. This matrix was always what? In one dimensional problem. A row. Now, here it is not. Here it is a rectangular matrix. Here it is a rectangular. For example, this one is 2 by 6. This is 6 by 1. And this is 2 by 1. Of course, if you multiply both left hand side, right hand side must come out to be the same thing, but then this is like this. So, we can put it. So, we are writing the theory in matrix form, and the reason for this is, why matrix? Because we have to make it automated. That means we have to write computer program, and matrices is the language of computer. So, this is how theory developed. So we can write it u vector approximated, I will just write it. This matrix we called shape function, this contains all the shape functions. So we denote it by a capital N, bold face N, this 2 by 6, and this one is nodal displacement. Nodal displacement, what is the term that we use? What is small d? Yes. So we got our first relation that u vector is approximately equal to n. Only thing is n has to be established. You have to find out n. You have to, so this okay. Next, so displacement, this is called, now how to get n, is the next question, how to get n, because n I have, notionally I have said yes, it is n1, n2, n3 shape function. What is the meaning of shape function? Its value is unity at 1, 0 over here. I should have a function in two dimension, a function in two dimension, function of x and y, which should have, so if you have a triangular shape, if you have a triangular shape object, how do you generate that kind of shape function? So this is triangle, this is a triangle. I want, this is, let us say this is my node number 1. Are you able to see on the screen? This is 1, 2, 3, let us say. So I want a function, two dimensional function, such that this is equal to, here the value is unity. So I just lift it, this plane, it is a plane, two dimensional triangle. I lift it, give a unit displacement here. So this equation of this inclined plane must represent, equation of this inclined plane in x and y must represent the shape function of node 1. This is the physical meaning of n1. It remains plane only. A triangle, if you hold these two points, yes, it will just lift like this. This is nonsense. So similarly node 2, it is same thing, hold it, lift this. Now this is the shape function of node 2, this is the shape function of node 3. So you have to write down the equation of the plane, inclined plane, and you know inclined plane equation, it will be a function of x and y. So meaning of n1, n2, n3 is this. Okay, so we were there, how to find out n1, n2, n3. So n1, n2, n3, plane is already, it is a plane. One thing is clear, I mean I have explained physically, it is a plane. So let, I will do it for u, and same thing will be for v also. U displacement, v displacement doesn't matter, you know. It is a it will have the same similar variation. So I will do it for u displacement. So let uxy be represented as a plane. What is the equation of a plane? I will write it a plus bx plus cy general. Linear, na? It is remaining, there need not be any quadratic how do you write down polynomial in two dimension? It should have constant, function in x, function in y, then x y, then x square, then y square, then y cube, all like this, you know, y cube, x square, y, how do you take polynomial, how do you, so this is the just I have taken the linear terms. But how do you take, do you know how to take the, let us say I tell you, please write down a polynomial of nth degree in two dimension, nth degree, this is first degree, here degree is 1, x to the power 1, y to the power 1, this is x to the power 0, a means constant 0, so nth degree, how will you write down? In one dimension it was straightforward. That is a0 plus a1x plus a2x square a3x cube, like this up to infinite. In two dimension how will you write down? Okay. No, any standard or any systematic way of writing down polynomial in two dimension, have you learnt in mathematics? You must have learnt. Have you heard about Pascal triangle? You cannot forget these things. Pascal triangle. What is Pascal triangle? Pascal triangle is like this. 1 x y. X. So, one line is going. Now, here there should be, because all quadratic terms must be there. So, what is the other possible x y? X into y quadratic term, then x cube, y cube, then from arrow will start from here also. So, it will be x square y cube cube x y square. So, on this line, on this horizontal line, this is cube, this is also cube, this is also all possible cube, I think only 4 terms. So, this will at least you will be able to know, yes, I am not leaving any terms. So, this can go up to 4th, any degree y 4. Now, then this line, what will be here? X cube y, then there will be x square y, a new arrow will start from here, then here x, nahi yahan galti ho gaya, yahan pa ye y rahega na, x cube y, and then this one will be xy cube. So, this is the up to 4th degree, all terms are included. Then there will be one more line starting, you know, arrow is starting from here, this will be going like this. So, like this, this rays keep on going. So, this is called Pascal triangle. You can also have Pascal triangle in 3 dimension, this is 2 dimension. 3 dimension it will be tripod, x, y, z. Z leg also will be there, you know, 3 legs of it, of a stool. So this is how. So, we are taking this for a triangle, we are taking this term A, we are taking this term and we are taking this term, and that forms also a triangle here also, because our plane is a, there is no quadratic term, it is plane, xy, linear function. So, we should take only that, unnecessarily you should not take terms, you know, which are not required. So, for 3 noded, just 3 terms are enough. So, this is all right. Then substitute, you have u1 means substitute the value at x1, y1. So, you will get u1 a plus b x1. C y 1. Substitute the value of node 2. So, you will get A plus b x 2 c y 2, and similarly the third node a plus b x 3 y 3. Next, we have just substituted the values of three nodes. There are three nodes, coordinates are x 1, y 1, etcetera. Then what should we do? I should write this in matrix form. Next is, best thing is to write down this in. So, u 1, u 2, u 3, here A, B, C, 1, x 1, y 1, 1, x 2, y 2, 1, x 3, y. See, it is very simple, pure geometry. I mean, see, what we are doing, we are trying to find out n. So, we said how to start. So, this is the starting point. Then I can find out A, B, C, the three undetermined coefficient as I'll have to find out inverse of this matrix. Inversion of this matrix, because all these coordinates are known, it is a known matrix. If you have three coordinates, this inverse let me see whether somewhere it is given. Determinant of the matrix comes in picture, because you have to find out inverse a triangle. So, determinant will come, and I am only looking for constant. Very surprising. A simple thing in you cannot find. One by, let me just from my memory, this is 1 by twice area of the triangle, 2 delta means, delta means area of the triangle. Then 2 delta, yes, then this one will be, this one will be x 2 y 2 minus x 3 y 2 y 2 minus y 3 x 3 minus x 2. So, what will be the next? Next one, y 2 y 3, x 2 y. So, it will be, sorry, x 2 y 3. X 2 y 3. So, it will be y 3, x 3, cyclic, x 2 y 3. So, x 3 x 3 y 1 minus x 1 y 3. Next one will be x1 y2 minus x2 y1. Yes, so we have got it. And then you see y2 y3, so it will be y3 y1 and y1 y2. This is x3 minus x2. So, this will be, next one will be cyclic. x3, see it involves 2 and 3, but then they involves 2 and 3. Then next one will be 3 and 1, so 1, 3, yes, x1 minus x3, and next one will be 1 and 2, 2, 1, 2, 1, so x2, now check up whether your, yes, looks like it is all right. So, this is the determinant multiplied by u1, u2, u3, yes, in. And delta, or 2 delta. Area of the triangle, twice the area of the triangle is given by determinant 1 1 1, x1 x2, ye to aap log kiye honge, y1. Area of a triangle is given by determinant of this, okay, this is twice the area of the triangle is determinant, this is determinant. This is will be a number. So, yes, we have got this. The ABC, what we have done in this process? We have found out ABC in terms of U1, U2, U3. ABC in terms of U1, U2, U3. So, if you substitute this back over here, it is looks here original ABC. If you substitute it here, so now you will get U in terms of U1, U2, U3. and then you can separate, you can take the coefficient of u1, coefficient of u2, coefficient of u3, and those will be n1, n2, n3s. So this is what is the basis of. So if you substitute it, so please substitute this, it will take time, it is simple algebra, so I will not do it, but you have got to do it, first time you have to do it. So we have all done this when we studied this, so please do it, complete, substitute it back there, and we can find out the coefficient of after substitution, after this, and once you substitute it, so I can write that n1, it comes out to be after substitution n1 xy will be equal to I will simplify this also, because there are so many, this is this matrix, I will write it again here, 1 by 2 delta b1 c1 d1 b2 c2 d2 b3 c3 d3 multiplied by u1 u2 u3. What is the meaning of b1? b1 is this quantity, nothing else, you know. I'm just writing by this another notation, because every time I don't have to write, so that I don't have to write. Think I will just tell. So, okay. So that is all. So I will say here n1 will be equal to 1 by 2 delta multiplied by b1 plus c1 x plus d1 y n2 x y 1 by 2 delta b2 plus c2 x plus d2 y and n3 x y 1 by 2 delta b3 plus c3 x plus d3 y, yes, that's right, it's correct, there is no mistake. In between I have just left some portion for you to do, so please do it. The shape function is known and it has the property that what I told you, it will have is it okay or not, or is there any mistake? No. So we have established n, basic thing is I told you I have put a question mark n, so now all the components of n are known, you can find out n, what is n, what is the equation, what is the two dimensional equation of, yes it is a function of xy, it is a two dimensional function xy, this is also xy, this is also xy, linear function of xy. And all these are numbers, b3, c3, d3 and delta is area of the triangle, 2 times area of the triangle. These are all numbers, so they will be simple numbers, okay. So when you do computation, these will all be numbers, okay. So this is how it will come. So it will not be this complicated. The but then we have established n, and therefore n is n. N matrix is now we have. So, first step is always in finite element is this, first step, because this is actually in reality this is the beginning of finite element, because finite element developed or started with this formulation. It was not done for one dimensional elastic axial rod problem, it was not done for a spring or truss problem, those were people knew how to solve it, you know, structural engineers. But now we are looking back, and then that is how we can say even those things can be now put in a finite element form. So, this is the real finite element, and why it is a real finite, because we are dealing now with continuum, it is a elastic body, it is not discrete element, there it was a rod, one dimensional rod, well defined two nodes, its stiffness was exact. Now, here, so first step in FE is this, U N D, somehow you have to do this, establish this. Choose an element and then establish this first step, and this is approximate, and that is why the method is approximate, and the error because of this is called discretization error. Got it or? Second step. Should we take the second step? What is the second step? After having established displacement, what is the next step? In any, to find out in any elastic continuum problem. Strains, strains in the body. How do you? So, we have got strains in the body. So, next step is 2. Strains. So, for example, this one, one strain is this. Second strain is at any point, third strain component that is present, there is one more strain component, which one? Yesterday I told you, yes, quickly you tell me which is the other strain component, quickly, one more strain component in there in plane stress problem. Epsilon z, but that is not independent, that can be found out by sigma x and sigma y once you find out, so it is not independent, you do not have to. So, this is your strain, so I can write this again in matrix form, whole of elasticity is written in matrix form, this is exact, there is no approximation here, we have not done any. So this is written as this matrix, what this is operator only, it contains derivatives, derivatives of u, derivatives of v, some derivative del upon del x. So, we call it operator matrix, operator, I think you must be knowing in mathematics it is called operator, matrix containing derivatives. So we denote this matrix by a letter L, capital L, operator matrix. And what is this U and V? U vector. And what is this left hand side we started with? Strain vector. So we have, now I can write the same scalar equations. So basically it is always possible to write down this for any elasticity problem. For any elasticity problem, you will always be able to write down this. There is no difficulty. LU. See, U is not approximate. After you write U equal to N into D, that is approximate. U is here. So, I have written exact. So, remember where. Now, U, now one more step I will just do and then I will. So, it is very good. So, second step is very simple. Now, so this is, we are still in strain. So, strain equal to L times U. And what is L? I have defined. I have defined it here. This is your L for this two dimensional problem, L operator matrix. And now I will substitute from the first, then it will be L into N, N times D. I will express strain also in terms of nodal displacement. So, U is already from the first step, it is N times D approximately. So, now this has become approximation. Now, I can, so this is del upon del x 0, 0 del upon del y, del upon del y and del upon del x. What is N matrix? N matrix was N1 0, N2 0, N3 0, 0 N1, 0 N2, 0 N3. Please do not forget, this is your N matrix, N we have defined earlier. N rectangular matrix, shape function matrix, and then that times D, and D you already know what is D, U1 V1, U2 V2, U3. So this is the meaning of this. So this is 3 by 2, and this is 2 by 6, and this is 6 by 1. And that is why this is 3 by 1. So, everything can be multiplied properly, there is no problem, 3 by 1 you will get. So, please multiply this and this. What will you get? You will get a 3 by 6, you will get a 3 by 6 matrix, 3 by 6. Please find out this 3 by 6 matrix here, write it down and then. So, you kindly complete this, and tomorrow when you come with this matrix. I came straight from home, so I have not brought the attendance. I will do it next time.